Stay tuned next for the Bad News Bears.
Let's go while the going's...
Mrs. Nelson needs her clock tomorrow, Michael. People are in such a hurry. But our work takes time, so we stay late. It's nice to know there are people who think about us and our needs. Like Northwest Federal, right here in the neighborhood, they're open more than anyone. So I save at Northwest Federal, even though they're not clock watchers.
It's Northwest Federal savings time. We've got more time for you.
There's only one Z-Bart, and there are 10 exclusive reasons why no one else, including your car dealer, can duplicate the Z-Bart Auto Truck rust-proofing system. Reason number one, our exclusive sealant that penetrates all areas, including seams, where rust can start. Ask your Z-Bart dealer to show you all 10 of the Z-Bart system exclusives that lengthen the life of your car. Z-Bart, it's us or rust.
32 convenient Z-Bart locations to serve you in the Chicago area.
There's a brand new store in town. It's called Zare.
Take another look, take another look, take another look at Zare. Take another look, look at all the fashions there. Take another look at Zare. Take another look, compare. Take another look, take another look, take another look at Zare. Take another look, look at all the values there.
Come on in and take a look
at Zare.
Pantrovia rides tonight, 10:30.
Bears. Sponsored by General Foods International Coffee. It's our flavor that makes us special.
You play that with such feeling, Barry?
I did that arrangement especially for you, Carol.
Well, I have something special for you. General Foods International Coffees to relax with.
Love that orange aroma.
I knew you would. It's orange cappuccino, and I'm in the mood for the chocolatey flavor of Swiss mocha.
Mmm, delicious.
Isn't it? Gives me a nice warm feeling, like old songs and special friends.
General Foods International Coffees, as much a feeling as a flavor.
There's a real nice thing going on in cities everywhere. A lot of city folk are turning into weekend farmers. They feel the way to get back to simple, basic foods is to grow it themselves. If they could grow their own cereal, it'd probably be grape nuts. It sure is simple. Crunchy little nuggets of wheat and barley with no preservatives. If the idea of simple foods is growing on you, start breakfast with Post Grape Nuts, the simple cereal.
I have never, in my entire life, seen three such filthy people. How anyone can get so dirty in just one morning is beyond my wildest imagination. Now...
All right, PhD, what's up? Some kid corralled me on my way to the car. Now, I got a pool to clean. Olympic size, jacuzzi, kidney-shaped tub. It's a big job. Lots of curves, lots of fungus.
I'll be glad to help you, Mr. Buttermaker.
Is fungus edible?
Well, look who's here. The Three Stooges.
I wanted you to look at them.
Can I go now?
Did you notice anything special about them?
They're short.
That's not it, Mr. Buttermaker.
Well, I'm stumped.
You flunk, Butternut.
Yeah, that's enough, boys. You may go. Not you, Mr. Buttermaker.
PhD, I got a date with the fungus.
Mr. Buttermaker, those children are dirtier than any pool you're going to clean.
Well, they're boys. They're supposed to be dirty. They've got the rest of their life to be clean.
It's never easy with you, Mr. Buttermaker, is it?
It's part of my charm.
No more going to class dirty. Starting today, you will please see to it that all of the boys take a shower after each game and after each practice.
Showers? Even after just practice? You're kind of cute when you're mad.
Everybody,
all right now. Now don't worry about it. I mean, you win one, you lose one.
We lose one, we lose another one.
That's very philosophical, Ahmad, but you got nothing to worry about. And you got nothing to be ashamed of. Ogilvy, what are the statistics?
Well, according to my calculations, Mr. Buttermaker, we're only 80% ineffective. Errors are down, strikeouts are down, drop balls are down, and Reggie only had one accident.
The bathroom should be closer to the dugout.
Now, Lupus, this is baseball. Eye on the ball, finger out of the nose. You remember that?
I'll try.
Good. Makes it easier to throw if your hands are free. All right, now listen up here. I got a little baseball surprise for you. How'd you like to be part of baseball history?
You bet you dinkus we would. What is bunting, stealing, hitting, spiking?
Showers.
Showers.
Grumblings. I see you forgot about the 69 Mets. They didn't have the hitting or the feeling of the other teams, but they won the World Series. And you know why? Showers. All right, come on now. Let's get in there and hit the soap.
Come on.
Showers. Buttermaker, I need a towel.
Amanda, are you crazy?
Mr. Buttermaker, I have to talk to you.
Later. Amanda, listen.
Mr. Buttermaker, it's important. I can't take a shower today. I have a bassoon lesson.
Hey, go ahead, but don't get hurt. Come here, we'll talk. Sit down, Mindy. You remember when you were at the beach? You were a little girl and you used to take off your top and romp around in public?
Yeah, so?
Well, it was cute, right?
If you say so, Buttermaker.
Well, I don't know if your mother got into this with you, but, well, there comes a time in every little girl's life, and that's you, when that top becomes something else. It...
Really? Why?
Well, it's like the team. I mean, they're nothing now, but, I mean, in time, they could develop in...
1 point for me. I have no intention of taking my clothes off in front of those guys.
Good.
Then take them off here.
What about me? I'm a guy.
No, you're gonna be outside. This will be my dressing room.
Well, wait a minute. This is my office on the coach. I look pretty stupid with my desk in the locker room.
Please, Buttermaker. Come on. Please.
All right.
Oh, thank you.
That's real good, Lucas. Now try it with some water. Okay, today's practice ends with hitting. Now I'm going to show you how to improve your hitting with a technique that was first used by the immortal Ty Cobb.
Is that in relation to corn on the cob?
Rudy.
All right, settle down. Now, what you do is plant your back foot so that when you start your swing, You can shift your weight to your front foot and bring your body into it. I'm going to show you how to do that with one thin dime.
A dime? That won't even bribe a cheerleader. Shut up, guys. Buttercred's trying to teach you something. He stinks, but at least he's trying.
Thanks, Tanner. You're first. I'm going to place this dime under your back heel.
That's stupid.
Thanks again. Now, I don't want you to take your foot off the dime. All right, Amanda, throw one in.
Fire it in there, Amanda!
Good hit. All right, everybody, shower time. Well, Amanda, I love what you did with my office.
Yeah, I like it too. Throw me a towel.
You know, somebody could walk in here and get the wrong idea about me. What's this guck? Wrinkle-proof cream. Does it work?
It's done wonders for me. It's just a beauty treatment.
Mr. Buttermaker, may I have a word with you?
Oh, sure, Ogilvy. What is it?
One, he's got another excuse for ducking the showers. Are you gonna let me con you again?
What's the matter, Amanda? You're the only one that's got an exclusive on the con? All right, Ogilvy. What can I do for you?
I can't take a shower today, Mr. Buttermaker. I have a bassoon lesson.
Ogilvy, so far this week you've had 3 bassoon lessons, 1 chess tournament, a calculus festival, and a biorhythm seminar.
I have diverse interests. Anyway, I believe childhood is for fun.
Well, I've got a new interest for you. It's called the joys of the shower.
But, I already have a very full schedule, Mr. Buttermaker.
Now, look, no buts, no cons, no excuses. You take a shower. You can take the bassoon in there with you. Now, go ahead.
You've got problems, Buttermaker. Something's wrong with him.
What a shower! Whatever it is, it'll all come out in the wash.
Hey, Buttercrud! Something's wrong with the cruddy showers. The cruddy water ain't coming out of the cruddy faucets.
You have to use that word all the time.
You got another word for water?
All right, stay calm, fellas. Stay calm now. Showers will be fixed. Just stay calm. No need to panic.
Hi.
Just another one of your interests? I don't want to be nosy. But just what are you doing here?
I'm checking the water level.
No.
Meditating?
No.
I'm turning off the showers.
That's more like it. Now give me that wrench and get in there and take a shower.
Want to, sir.
All right, that does it, Ogilvy. You're gonna take a shower. Now I want to see your bare butt in there by the time I count 3. 3.
Ogilvy has to take a shower.
No, I won't.
Come on, let's get his pants.
Ogilvy!
Recipe for saving money. Kool-Aid unsweetened.
I remember my mom serving us Kool-Aid. We loved it so much, sometimes she'd even treat us to a second pitcher. She could, because it was so inexpensive.
Still is. With my sugar, Kool-Aid unsweetened is about 13 cents a quart.
Has vitamin C, too. Anyone for more Kool-Aid?
Yeah!
Kool-Aid brand unsweetened soft drink mix. You loved it as a kid, you trust it as a mother.
Presents for the future, pink and baby blue. It would be so perfect if sis could be here too. Reach out and touch someone. Sharing your feelings, a special surprise for rocking the night away. Reach out
and touch someone far away. Give them a call.
Monday, Snoopy's at it again, and it's the Easter Beagle, Charlie Brown.
Easter Beagle will never let you down.
Then, on the White Shadow, Thorpe must face the music when the team forms a band.
We took a vote, man. You out of it.
On the White Shadow at a special time. Next, the headline.
See, they believe in mercy killing.
And a spa's the setting for a secret mob meeting.
My paper knows exactly what time we're leaving here and what time we're expected to arrive in L.A.
Lou Grant, 1/2 hour earlier, Monday.
This was a very good idea, Mr. Buttermaker. Sharing our noon repast.
Repast? I like to think of it as lunch. You know, I thought we could take this time to talk about things like life, baseball, and your problems with the shower.
I don't want to talk about it.
Holy zuts. Something die in there?
Oh, no, sir. This is camembert cheese.
Yeah, well, keep it downwind, huh? Bobby's getting sick. No, Ogilvy, if you got a problem, you can talk to me. I'm your coach. I mean, that's like a priest or a minister, except the uniform's different.
I appreciate your concern, Mr. Buttermaker, but I'm too embarrassed to talk about it.
All right, then I'll talk. You can't go in the shower because, well, water is a religious thing.
That's not it.
You're allergic to tile.
No such allergy exists, Mr. Buttermaker.
The towels ain't fluffy enough.
Towels are fine.
Soap?
Fine.
Everything's fine.
Fine.
Fine. Then all you have to do is go into the locker room, take your clothes off, and walk into the shower. Now, taking your clothes off ain't hard, is it? I said taking your clothes off ain't hard, right? And again, maybe it is. That's it. You're ashamed to take your clothes off in front of people. Is that it? Hey, that's all right. Come on. Listen, that's nothing. Look, if you don't want to take your clothes off in front of people, you don't have to. Besides, the bears ain't people anyway. Yeah? I got a smile on you, huh?
I feel so childish.
That's because you're a child. You're supposed to be childish. You think that's bad? You know, when I was a kid, I had real red hair. People used to call me Carrot Top. And I hated it.